We're out here specifically tonight and last night because lots of people think that since Joe Biden is president, things are like better, things are okay now, they don't have to do anything. We want to show that we don't believe that. We're not going to get complacent. We're still going to try to help people as much as possible, no matter who's president.
Why are you out here? What are you passionate about?
I'm passionate about reform. I'm passionate about changing things and believing in change. I'm passionate about abolishing places that put kids in cages.
Having Joe Biden as president doesn't change things for you?
No. Nope.
How come?
Because it's still president, it's still government. It's not gonna change. I mean, Kamala Harris is still a cop. Joe Biden is still the president, and it's not gonna change.
But he has a different philosophy towards different things.
It's still the same political system, and the system that is the issue. I'd like to see complete change.
What are the main issues for you?
Immigration, education, and defunding the police.
I want to see Medicare for all. I want to see funding pulled away from police departments and funneled into organizations within communities that actually help build up the communities, rehabilitation centers for people who have addictions, communities where the houseless can get off of the streets and get back on their feet and be able to live in homes instead of in tents. Immigration is, to me, a non-issue. We are in a world of absolute abundance. There is so much wealth in this country that is not being distributed to the people. It is being hoarded by a small percentage of people who exploit their workers. And there is no reason for people to be told that they can't come here when we have all of these resources available. There are so many empty houses in this country. There are so many empty apartment buildings, but there are so many people who are living on the street because they can't afford to pay that bill. And I don't think that that's reasonable. I don't think it's rational, and I don't think it's moral at all.
But with Joe Biden as being president, that doesn't change your mindset at all, like in terms of the...
Until I see the tangible changes that come with his administration, I keep him at an arm's length. The Democratic Party and the Republican Party are two branches of the same tree, and I think that we need a forest.
So some people thought with having Biden as president that you wouldn't see the type of protesting we saw last night and the violence that came with it and the vandalism.
I think that those people need to look at Joe Biden's records of how he has voted on certain laws in Congress and Kamala's history as a prosecutor and a cop and realize that there's absolutely no reason based off their histories and their policies that we would stop these protests because they still defend the things that we are fighting against. It's not boo Donald Trump, boo Republicans. It's boo funding the police, boo police brutality, and boo an unjust system.
And what do you make of the vandalism that occurs?
I don't do vandalism myself, but destruction of property is a fundamentally American form of protest dating back to the Boston Tea Party, and I'm not here to tell somebody else how to protest.
Do you think there should be?
I think it's up to the individual. If that is what you think you have to do to get your point across and show your government that that's where you stand, then by all means, you do you. I've seen some vandalism that is absolutely gorgeous street art. I've seen some that the penmanship leaves something to be desired, but it's not my place to police someone's protest.
But busting out windows and breaking glass and those kinds of things?
In comparison to the issues that we are protesting, those seem like very small problems to me. There is a lot of anger and rage, and there's a lot of hopelessness in people my age and people I know who feel like no matter how you vote, no matter what you do, they're not listening. A riot is the language of the unheard.